You have a business problem, and you translate that into a mathematical model. That is, I think, the most important part of operations research. And one paper in particular is about bike sharing systems. You have to make sure that when a user wants to use a bike, it should be there. And when you want to drop off the bike, it should be an empty spot. The issue we have is that, of course, during commute hours, people will go from one place to their work environment and then they want to go back in the afternoon and they commute. And so you get piles of bikes in one part of the day and one area of town. And of course, there's a lot of demand of bikes that you cannot deliver perhaps. So you get an imbalance in these bike stations and in the inventory in terms of bikes. And also in terms of parking spaces. We have a predictive model, a mathematical model that describes at each part of the day, say 8 a.m. or 9 a.m., how many people want to get a bike from this station and how many people want to drop off their bike at this station. And now it's our role as an optimization or an operations researcher to make sure that we redistribute the bikes over time so that we have enough of this demand fulfilled. So we have to design these routes for these trucks to pick up a certain amount here, deliver it there. And so we use the predictive model to get a lower and upper bound on an interval in what is the level of inventory at each of these stations. And we then optimize the routes of the trucks to make sure that we are within those bounds and we can meet as much demand as we can in the, say, coming 2 or 3 hours. It's a very challenging problem, but we found a way to decompose it into independent smaller clusters that can be rebalanced independently, and that scales dramatically better.